classic Def Leppard song. We love it. In fact, we're very excited to have our next guest here. Rick Allen, he is a musician, humanitarian, visual artist, and hero. For 30 years, he's been the drummer for the legendary band Def Leppard. At the height of the band's success, a near-fatal car accident caused Rick to actually lose his arm.
But Rick fought back, fought all the odds, went back on the road. He also became a visual artist with a series of Drums for Peace now, honoring his years of working with injured veterans. And fans can see his artwork tomorrow at Wentworth Gallery in Short Hills, New Jersey. Please welcome Rick Allen.
That's great. Thank
great
you guys.
To have you here. It's so funny, we were just talking about finding the time for this beautiful artwork and then also with your music and with Def Leppard. You started when you were 15 years old.
No, I know. I was so fortunate. I was one of those kids that came straight out of school. And obviously my parents, they didn't think I was going to be a brain surgeon. And they said, you know, let him go, let him follow his dreams. And that's exactly what I did. I got a private tutor and I ended up staying with Def Leppard. And it was, you know, it's one of those success stories.
So what came first, the music or the artwork?
The artwork came first. When I was a kid, I used to get more paint on, you know, on me than anything else. And then I discovered music around about 9 or 10 years old. And then when my youngest daughter was born, when she was old enough, we started painting together. Mm-hmm. And that's when it reignited my passion.
When did you get hurt? When was your accident?
My accident was actually the end of 1984, the last day of 1984. So I ruined everybody's New Year's celebrations.
Year's Eve. Oh my God.
New Year's Eve.
How old were you? Explain what
21.
Happened.
21. Yeah. And I was driving my car down country roads, left-hand drive car in England, didn't see the corner, went around the corner, rolled the car, and the seatbelt actually came undone, and that was the thing that took my arm.
So you were by yourself?
I was actually with my girlfriend at the time.
Okay. Yeah. Well, it didn't stop you.
No,
yeah,
not
talk
at all.
About the road back. I mean,
no,
you,
I know.
A fighter.
At first, when I first came around in hospital, it was like, it's all over. I'm done. But then encouragement from my family, from the guys in the band, and then hundreds of thousands of letters from all over the planet. And it was at that point when I discovered the power of the human spirit.
Uh-huh.
And that was really what propelled me. And I was like, I can do this. And once I took that step, then
the
here
technique
we are.
Changed, but it's still Rick.
Yeah, exactly. All the information was there. I just needed to channel it out in a different way so I could express myself differently. A very good friend of mine created some foot pedals, and I was able to play an electronic drum kit, a version of electronic drum kit as opposed to the acoustic drums. Still play acoustic drums, but it's easier for me to express myself using the electronic
and
drums.
How about the artwork? Let's talk about some of that. It hasn't affected your artwork at all,
no,
right?
No. Okay. And the wonderful thing about the artwork, it's really just another way to express myself. And the fantastic thing is this, I go to the same place when I play music. It's that being in the moment and just, it's actually really therapeutic. And it really helps with my PTSD, mm-hmm. Which is obviously one of the connections with the vets.
Right.
And that is one thing, or, you know, this along with the music has been so therapeutic, so helpful for me just to cope with certain triggers.
The significance of the palm print there.
Well, it's kind of, you know, I do everything.
It's your hand,
I do,
right?
That's it. It's you know, everything I've relearned, everything that comes to me now has to come through this or, you know, my feet. Mm-hmm. So.
I love the fact that you have the American flag. You're an Englishman in New York. It's fantastic.
I live here, and it's.
Oh, you do? You live in New York?
No, I don't actually live. I have family here. My wife, you know, she's born here, but so I have family and everything. But I'm actually out on the West Coast. But yeah, I figure I live in America. America has given me all this freedom, mm-hmm. to express myself either with my music and now
with,
you know, this is
how much
something
does something like this go for, by
I have
the way.
No clue.
It goes for $4,000. Would you like to know? $4,595.
Look at you.
Are you interested?
Yes. All right, let's
get to the next one.
Fantastic. Was this actually part of a drum kit that you used?
Yeah, I had these drums at home, and then I thought, well, how can I just decorate these drums and make them, you know, because I've got art to wear.
So you have other drums you've done this with as well.
Yes, and then this is art to play. So, you know, I wouldn't recommend
Lori, how much, Lori?
All right, that would be $9,995.
Ouch.
Let's take a look at the last one. Well, this is kind of interesting the way you did this.
Well, his master's voice. Def Leppard's first album cover, or sorry, EP cover, mm-hmm. was actually a leopard sitting here. So I said, how can I do a different take on that? So I figured, you know, do the original sort of his master's voice and then do all the, you know.
But we still see the red, white, and blue.
Yeah, they.
Lori, how much?
Oh, that would be $1,895.
Oh, we should get that. We'll check that.
Let's get that.
By the way, so everybody can see your artwork tomorrow.
In Short Hills, right? In the Wentworth Gallery.
Yeah, the Wentworth.
Wentworth Gallery at the Mall of Short Hills on Morris Turnpike, 1200 Morris Turnpike in Short Hills.
Yeah. Oh, cool. What time will you be there?
I think that's 5 to 8. Yeah,
somebody, it is 5 to 8.
5 to 8.
Okay. Yes,
and
it
then
is.
I think on Sunday I do King of Prussia.
Oh, so that's fun.
Yeah, wonderful.
I love that place, too. Yeah, that's great. Yeah. It's such an honor to have you here.
Fantastic.
Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for inspiring us. And
You know, it's... It's a good deal, you know. I just share my life experience, and it's fantastic. People welcome me everywhere I go. It's lovely.
Hey, when is Def Leppard going back on the road?
I can't talk about that.
But what do you mean, Def?
You
got to give us a little something, Rick, before you go.
I think so this year, but I didn't get the memo yet. I'm planning on going on vacation.
Oh.
But I'm sure when I get the memo, I won't be.
Okay, gotcha. I like your style. Rick Allen, all the best.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for being here.
We have another musical genius.